Hello, my name is Evan Duffield. In this video, we're going to be talking about Dash's virtual corporation, which is one of the most innovative things that we've done and also one of the most exciting things. This is because we take all of the efficiencies from a centralized corporation and mix them with all of the efficiencies from a decentralized autonomous corporation. And combined together, we make something that's nearly completely efficient. So how do we do that exactly? Well, to start out, we need to talk about boring old corporations. And these are the types of corporations that everyone's really used to dealing with on a day-to-day basis, such as Target, PayPal, eBay. And these are what the world economy is built on. So they were quite efficient and innovative for a very, very long time. But everything about them centralized from start to finish. They get VC that's centralized, they spend it using centralized methodologies, then they develop revenue streams which go through centralized banks, from centralized people to centralized people, and then they spend it using a management and decision-making system which is also centralized in nature. But it's super efficient. So how do we get all of the efficiency of a system like that and then combine it with a decentralized autonomous corporation and get the total efficiency of both systems together? Well, in a decentralized system, we really do need some form of governance, management, funding, infrastructure that's paid for. We need salaried staff, we need contractors, we need to pay for legal expenses, and all sorts of things. And to do this in a way that remains decentralized is really the issue. And so what we've decided that needs to be done and that we've created is, first you start out with a leader. And that's the person that organizes this virtual corporation. And then after that person has the vision for the project and has gotten some interested people to work with them, then they start to lay the foundation for how the company actually functions. So in our case, we have small teams all around the world. We have a PR team, we have a marketing team, we have a software development team, and a project management team. And all of this is done using our recurring revenue stream. And our recurring revenue stream is basically the seed funding for the virtual corporation. And that's automated, trustless, and decentralized. This makes us the very first working decentralized autonomous corporation in history, because we have every component of the company automated from start to finish, and it's all modeled economically with incentives all around. So every participant is actually motivated in some way. Our virtual corporation is also growth-oriented. And this means that we take money from the network itself in a trustless, decentralized way, and then we try to spend it to earn ROI for the network itself. Alternatively, a centralized corporation would take money from its investors, and then it would try to spend it to create revenue streams, which then it could use to hire employees and build locations and get infrastructure and things like that. So we work kind of similarly, but in a completely decentralized way. So why would you want to work for our virtual corporation? Well, for one thing, we've solved all of the problems within cryptographic currency, and we were the ones that did it. And so this is a historic event, and you can work for a company that's like no other. And after all of this is said and done, I mean, we are making some of the most amazing technology that exists currently. So who wouldn't want to work for us? Being growth-oriented by design is also one of the most important aspects of being a centralized corporation. And so it's one of the most important aspects of being a virtual corporation also. We want to earn an ROI for the network. And the reason for this is that we have a given amount of Dash every month that we can spend. And so if we spend it in the smartest possible way, we'll have more budget money every month which leads us to being able to hire more developers or more employees to do marketing and PR and public awareness, or better salaries and better opportunities in general, because some opportunities cost more money. And if we have more money, we can utilize more of the money to do these things that we want to do, which then even draws in more money and creates more ROI, so we can actually grow this company really, really fast. Everyone wins that's involved. This is a virtuous cycle. All of our investors win because the price appreciation benefits them as well. The employees win because they're working on some of the coolest technology that's ever existed. And all of this works to decentralize the project further. As the project gets bigger, we can get more people and we can get better technology, etc. And then every aspect of this stimulates innovation. Innovation is stimulated because as we create new technology, we might end up creating a technology to draw in a specific segment of a specific country into the currency. And when we do that, that money comes in, which causes price appreciation, and then that expands our budget even further. And again, the virtuous cycle just continues. What about founding the virtual corporation early on? In centralized corporations, they have investors and they have founders, and those people are the ones that get the original issuance of the shares. And the founders are incentivized because they essentially get the shares for free oftentimes. And so they want to work on it to make the shares more valuable. In a virtual corporation, however, it's really murky because the currency is also the shares, is also a commodity. And so they serve multiple purposes throughout the ecosystem. And what we need to do is figure out, how do you make one of these entities in a stable way to incentivize all of the parties all around? In the Bitcoin project, it was relatively unknown for the first couple years. And so the founders collected a lot of coins, which we'll call their shares, because that's what's incentivizing them to work on the project. And in the rest of crypto, this is actually looked at as a bad thing now. With Dash, we made an accidental discovery in the beginning. We had some kind of similar incident in the beginning when a lot of the currency was given out to the community, and our founders came out of that. And so now we have a few founders with a decent position within the currency, which we'll call their founding shares, and that's incentivizing them to work on the project. And we anticipate that this is actually a requirement for these types of entities to work properly. They need to be incentivized. So how do you do this in a fair way? If you give the founders coins, they could dump them on the market at any time, hurting all of the investors. Well, in a centralized corporation, we have another example. And that is that there is disclosure that's required for selling coins on a publicly traded company. And we believe that virtual corporations should be the same way. How much of the virtual currency should actually go toward the founders themselves? In the case of something like Apple, we're dealing with just shares. And so you have investors and you have the founders that have shares. And those are oftentimes different classes of shares. But in a virtual currency, we only have one type of token. And so we need to split up that token for the different groups of people so that we can incentivize them all properly. What we would recommend is about 10% goes to the founders, then 70% to the infrastructure, and then the last 20% to the currency itself. However, this isn't how Dash was set up originally. This is just how we believe a virtual corporation should be set up in the future to be completely successful. We actually discovered this accidentally because there was an error in the code in the first 24 hours that created a lot of coins. And some of those went to the founders and some of those went to the community. And then over the next month, there was a lot of selling on the exchanges, which separated those that wanted to be founders from those that just wanted to make a little money. In Dash, all of the founders have less than 10% of the currency. And you can compare that to Bitcoin, where over the first 2 years, there was about 6 million coins issued of 21 million. It's a what about automating business functions? It's really important to note that every part of our virtual corporation is actually automated. So we've automated the capital reinvestment because it takes the network to do that. We've automated governance because it also takes the network's approval to do that. And our infrastructure is incentivized as well. The only thing that is automated within a more classic cryptocurrency like Bitcoin is the production. How about our corporate roles? Every aspect of those is also automated. Full nodes are automated with our second tier network. The decision making is automated with our decentralized governance and budgeting system. And then our workforce and suppliers are automated through our core team, who manages that for the network. From a technical level, all of this works through decentralized trustless technology. And that's why it's all automatic. Some of the decentralized technology that we use for the funding mechanism is called the decentralized governance and budgeting system. And essentially what this does is it gauges the interest of the second tier network in any decision that needs to be made about where to spend money or what to do. And by utilizing this network, the second tier network, and the thousands of people that manage it, we actually gain the wisdom of the crowd, which means that when you take the opinions of thousands of people that know a lot about a given topic, and then you ask them a question about that topic, the majority of them should know what to do about it. And then we should be able to make the right decisions most often of the time. All of this utilizes the human element plus automation in a way that is mixed together to provide as perfect efficiency as possible. So this is it for our virtual corporation video. In the next video, we'll be covering the incentive structures and the masternode network.